URS came to us with the issue that they wanted to be able to have a partial barrier here to be able to prevent them from leaving, or to let the staff know when someone is leaving with some alarm system or something like that. So we had to come up with some sort of adaptive barrier and also follow all ADA guidelines, be removable, adhere to fire code, and be able to withstand any sort of impact from any wheelchairs or anything like that.
This was one of those projects that was just much more complicated than what we normally do for United Rehabilitation Services. The skills that were required were not simple, and they had to do a lot of independent learning and troubleshooting. And the biggest challenge was just time, and the time was much shorter than a normal semester to get this done.
We had 3 days that we were set to go into the facility to install. It was the week before we got sent home for Thanksgiving break. The first 2 days went as planned, and then we came up on our final day on Monday. However, by the end of that day, our electrical components with our buttons were not working out.
They were supposed to be done on Monday, and it didn't work.
We had everything we needed right there, but things were just weren't clicking. And when we walked out of that facility Monday, there was this big sense of like loss of hope. We were like, what are we gonna do?
And they decided they'd find a way to fit in a few extra hours of work, do some research that night, and make sure everything was up and running successfully. So it was literally just Joe. And he said, well, I will stay until it's done.
When I finally got the electrical components to work appropriately and it all was working, I really let out this scream of joy in the facility. Some of the clients were like, what's wrong, what's wrong? And I'm like, no, nothing, like, it all worked. And I was just thrilled.
The one thing that Dayton has done so well is the fact that they recognize that all of us are born with all these unique gifts. And once you learn to serve for the rest of the greater good of the community, then you learn to become the best engineer and you learn to become the best person for the rest of the world.
When I was a junior in high school, I actually had lost my dad to cancer. And because I'm the oldest of four boys in my family, I really had the plan that I was gonna stay at home, commute to a local school, and to do what I can to help raise the rest of my brothers. That scholarship that I received, it opened a whole world of opportunities up for me. And I would not be here without that scholarship. And whatever I do from this point on is really because of the scholarship.
It was clear to me that, you know, this was a gift and he was using that gift to truly make a difference during his time here. And as a professor, I'm thankful for the donors. I'm thankful for the donors who provide support to get these wonderful, extraordinary students here on campus who are truly making a difference.
It changed my life, and it definitely changed the direction of where I was gonna go for the rest of my life. And now that I leave here, I can definitely say I'm gonna become not only the best engineer I can be, but the best person I can be for the rest of the people that I do serve from this point on when I do leave the University of Dayton.